presumably we're finally going to get to see a little bit of your interpretation of Lex Luthor soon. Was that a tough character for you to crack? I know you can't say much, but just in terms of like taking on such an iconic role, did it feel like there was any particular challenge that made it worthwhile for you in doing it?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I don't think of it as a challenge that's worthwhile. I mean, it was a wonderful opportunity, worthwhile. Like, it's a really great character. It was written by this guy, Chris Terrio, who's a phenomenal writer.
Did Argo, right? And yeah.
Yeah, but I mean, he comes from a place of character. He loves my character in the same way I love my character. Like, he put a lot of work into it. It's a great character. There's an emotional core to the character. It's not a silly, villainous character. So, no, it was a great part.
Did you have any appreciation or awareness of, like, what... Because growing up, I loved what Gene Hackman did with that role. It's obviously a much different kind of a take, I would assume. But did was that something on your mind at all in terms of going a different way or referring back to those?
No, I mean, there's no way to do anything. I mean, it's an entirely different thing. But also, the tone of that movie is so different. Like, that movie wouldn't be made like that now. Right. Like, the way we expect movies to be now is to have some kind of, like... I mean, it's for the best, probably, because there's some kind of more psychological accuracy.
Sure.
That the person is coming from a place, you know, that's probably diagnosable in some ways.
Yeah, I mean, that movie was almost done with a little bit of a wink.
Yeah, exactly. Right. This is not. This is a real, like, a depiction of a person who's, like, who thinks these things.